Hey guys, welcome back. In this lecture, we will be talking about yet another very important concept that exists in codeless programming, and that is lists. Lists, or sometimes they're known as arrays or collections, all those terms refer to exactly the same concept, is first of all, a separate data type. In fact, when we talked about strings, numbers, booleans, we kind of skipped lists or arrays, for the reason that I waited till we get to this point to introduce that. But yes, it is indeed a separate data type. In fact, if we were to go back to this block right here that determines the type, the data type of a value, there is going to be one that is called array. And then this array, whenever it's selected, it will determine whether a value that you're working with is of that data type. So what is a list or array or collection? Well, first of all, it is a data structure that may contain actually zero or more elements in it. The elements in a list may be of the same data type. So a list may contain a collection of string values or collection of numbers, collection of booleans. It may contain a collection of arrays or a collection of objects. And we haven't really discussed objects yet. But it may contain values of different data types. So the same list may contain some strings and some numbers. That would be kind of unusual, but sometimes if the application calls for that and you have a use case, there is really nothing that stops you from creating a list that contains kind of different data values of different data types. So every single element in a list has its own index. In Codeless, they start with 1, so the first element in the list has index of 1, second index of 2, and so on. Additionally, a list has a property of length. So you can, for any given list, you can get the length of that list, and it will tell you how many items are in that list. Let's see what else. So a list supports all kinds of different operations. You can create lists, of course. You can shrink them by removing some items. You can append items to a list to add more to it. You can search within a list. You can find an index of a specific value. You can iterate over a list, and this is where loops will come in handy, because you will be able to go over that list and identify and work with each individual element. There are ways to do sorting and filtering. And in the coming lectures, you will learn all about it. In fact, in Codeless, there is a category called lists right here. And you see it has 20 different blocks. In fact, all of these blocks, they do something with lists. And we will be going over not all of them in this lecture, but in this one and the subsequent ones, we will be exploring pretty much every single operation that is supported by a list. To start working with lists, let's create one and inspect it and see what it contains. For this, I will create a variable, and I will call this variable rainbow. And that variable, as you might have guessed, will contain rainbow colors. So to create a list, and there are different ways to create a list, and we will explore all of them in this lecture. If you go into the lists category, you'll see this block create list with connected to that variable. And let's take a look at this block right here. You see it has these three connectors, and for each one, you can add an item. In this case, those will be strings representing different colors of the rainbow. If you need to have more, click on the gear icon, and you can drag this item element right here to this list block. And every time you add one, there's gonna be one connector added right here. It works identical as with the if-else block, if you remember. We were able to add additional else-if blocks, and those connectors were created. Anyway, let's add a text block and connect it to a connector, and I will replicate the text block and connect them all. And as soon as it's done, let's assign colors to these string values. So we have red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and purple. So now this block creates our list that contains those string values, and that list is going to be put into the rainbow variable. Let's print out the value of that variable. So if we use print and then drag our variable out here, let's run this page and see what we actually get. So what's going to be inside of that rainbow variable. So in here, it prints out the whole list as just one line. You can actually expand it in console. And as you can see, these are the values that were placed into that list. And there's also length property, which has the number, which basically is the number of how many elements are in that list. And there are six. Something to note here is the very first one shows up as zero, which will be kind of slightly disconnected from what I said earlier, because I said that the first one has the index of one. Indeed, in Codeless, whenever you work with lists, the first item will have index of one. Whenever you print it out in console, it's going to be shifted by one because it is zero based. Ignore that for now. It's not going to get in the way at all, because in Codeless, whenever you work with lists, with all that logic, you'll just need to remember that the first item in your list will always have index of one. So now that this is our list, and it now supports all kinds of different operations, iteration, adding to it, removing, searching, and so on. But right now, I would like to focus on different ways to create lists, and let's explore that. So here, by the way, since we talked about length, let's also look into the usage of this length of block. So in lists, you see this length of, and let's print the value of that length of out to the console. So connect length of to print, and then connect the variable that contains our list to this length of. And what this will do is it will print out the value, which is the size of our list, which is 6. So here the length of just returns this numeric value, and we take this value and put it into console, but nothing stops you from creating a variable or using this the result of length of as the input for another block, just like with everything else in Codeless. Okay, so what's the other way to create the same kind of list? If you go into lists, you will see there is a block that is going to be, I'm looking for it right now, right here, make list from text. Okay, and this make list from text is kind of a very convenient block whenever you have long text that you just want to split up into individual elements. Let me demonstrate how it works, and you will basically see it in action. I will create a new variable that will call that will be called new rainbow, and let's set this new rainbow to contain the result of this one. So list from text. It means that in here we actually have to put some text. Let's put this block in here. And what's going to go in here is the same values. In our case, we can separate them by a comma. So again, it's going to be red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. Let's take a closer look now. So we have this string that contains all of these values separated by comma, and notice that there is this with delimiter that includes comma. So what's going to happen is Codeless will take that string, which is basically one whole string, and it will break it up into individual values where comma is used as a separator, as the delimiter, and it will create a new list that will be stored in this new rainbow variable. Let's print out new rainbow like this, and take a look at it. So notice that this is the result of printing out new rainbow, and it is exactly the same list that contains exactly the same values, for the reason that it's actually going to be an identical structure with identical values, but created differently. Guess what? You can use any delimiter as that works for you. So for instance, if we were to change this string, and instead of commas, use the space character. And in here, let's remove this comma and put the space. Then this string will still be processed using space character as the delimiter. And if I run it, you see, we still got exactly the same list. So the parsing process of this string will be driven by whatever delimiter you put in there. If you want to put semicolon, that's fine. So you put semicolon here, it will still be broken down into individual values. So these are two different ways to create your lists. Can you create an empty list? Absolutely. If you go into lists, there's going to be a block that is called create empty list right here. And in here, it's actually a sort of a replica of this block without any items in there. If you drag one in, then it becomes create list with, just like this guy. Without any, it's going to be empty list. An empty list has the length of zero. So in fact, let's create an empty list and just print out what it looks like right here. The very last printout will be our empty list. Right here, you see, the empty list has no elements. The length is zero. Sometimes it is useful where you need to create a list and then as your logic proceeds, it will basically be accumulating some values in this list. And in this case, having that empty list, basically preparing that structure, that placeholder is going to be important. Let's see, what else do we have here as far as list creation? There is a block that looks like this. And just by looking at it, you can guess what's going to happen. It reads create list with item, and there is an item specified, repeat it, and then specific number of times. Sometimes, and this is more of a convenience block because you can simulate the work of this block with some additional codeless logic, but here this is more of a convenience with a single block. Sometimes you need to create a list that contains same value replicated multiple times. Let's say it could be just some kind of a binary map or, you know, some whatever it is. I cannot even come up with an example, but those use cases do exist. So in this case, let's see how that works. So here I will create a list with item, and that item, let's say it's going to be just a number. Okay, so let's say we want to create a list that contains just a bunch of ones. Repeat it, for instance, 50 times. So this will create that list where we have 50 elements in that list, and each element is number one. And let's run it. And as you can see, here's our list that contains all of these ones 50 times. There will be 50 elements starting from in the display from 0 to 49, but in Codeless it's going to be from 1 to 50. So that's yet another way to create a list, but in a more specialized kind of way. Another way to create a list is by combining two lists together. So you, in whatever the logic is, you may come up with one list and then you have another list and you need to join them. In our case, we do have two lists. One of them is called is in the variable called rainbow. And another one is in a variable called newRainbow. In fact, they do contain exactly the same data. And let's see what happens if we combine those two lists together into one. And for that, if we go and use this block, and it says list combined with, and here's another connector, and we will print out what that will do. And then in here, we will use variable rainbow, and in here, we will use variable newRainbow. So let's do this and then drag the newRainbow. There you go. So now rainbow and newRainbow will be combined, and the combined value is returned back, which means that neither rainbow nor newRainbow are modified. In fact, a third list will be created, and then the third list is what's returned out from this block. Let's run it and see what that looks like. All right, so here it is. Now we have this list that contains 12 items indeed, because rainbow had 6 and new rainbow had also 6. But now there are 12 of them. And as you can see right here, this part came from rainbow and then this part came from new rainbow. But in the resulting list, they're all just individual elements of that final third list that was created. And again, in certain algorithms and whatever the logic is, there may be a need to combine lists together. There you have it. So we talked about creation of lists, three different ways, and we talked about combining lists. And then in the next lecture, we will talk about adding items to a list and retrieving items from a list. I do hope you found this useful. Thank you for watching this video, and as always, happy Codeless coding.